the Lord said to Philip, go south to the west, the desert west. The water goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza. So he started out, and on his way, he met an Ethiopian eunuch, and kept an official in charge of all the treasury of Kadaki, which he had with an Ethiopian. This man had gone to Jerusalem to worship, and on his way home, was sitting at his chariot, reading the book of Isaiah the prophet. The Spirit told Philip, go to that chariot and stay near it. The Philip ran out to the chariot and heard the man reading Isaiah the prophet. Do you understand what you were reading? Philip asked. How can he say, unless someone explains it to me? So he invited Philip, come up and sit with him. This was the passage of scripture the eunuch was reading. He was led like a sheep to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearer is silent, so he did not open his mouth. In humiliation, he was deprived of justice. Who can speak as his sentence, for his life was taken from the earth? The eunuch asked Philip, who is the prophet talking about? Himself or someone else? This Philip began that very passage of scripture and told him the good news about Jesus. As they traveled along the river, they came to the water, and they said to Philip, what? Here is water. What can stand in the way of me being baptized? And he gave orders to stop the chariot. Then both Philip and the eunuch went down into the water, and Philip baptized him. When they came up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord suddenly took Philip away, and the eunuch did not see them again, but went on his way rejoicing. Philip, however, appeared in a vision and traveled about, preaching the gospel to all the tribes until he reached Caesarea. This is a word from the Lord. O Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight. This I pray. So Philip is not one of the 12. Jesus did not call him to him, asking him to follow me and become one of my disciples. Yet the community of faith that was created following the crucifixion of Jesus, his resurrection, and his ascension to the Holy Spirit, as recorded in Acts chapter 2, recognized something special within this man. And so Philip was called to serve this fledgling community of faith, this small church in Jerusalem, as a temple minister, or as a deacon of this early church. The 12 apostles saw the church in Jerusalem. They saw that it was growing rapidly, and that now some of the saints were beginning to exceed their ability to oversee this ministry. So a complaint arose among the people that some of the widows in the group were being neglected in terms of not only care, but food provision. So the 12 gathered disciples together and said it would not be right for us to neglect the ministry of the Word of God in order to wait on ourselves. Brothers and sisters, choose 7 men from among you known to be full of spirit and of wisdom. We will turn this responsibility over to them so we can get power and comfort to prayer and ministry of the Word. And so Philip was one of the men chosen for this task, along with Stephen, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas. If I were to be a temple minister, I'd be one of the Pharisees tell them to come and join this struggling place. And the village is recorded as becoming the first evangelist, telling people outside of Jerusalem to the Judea all about Christ. And he brought over many converts to his ministry. And the angel of the Lord came to Philip and said, You are to go south on the desert road, the one that connects Jerusalem to Gaza. Now, this is a harsh road. It is in the middle of a desert. This climate is very rough. It's scorching hot during the day, it's cold at night, and there's little to no water. On this road, Philip encounters an amazing sight. There is a traveler on this road heading south towards Africa in the Sea of Galilee. Philip sees right away that this traveler is not ordinary, but rather this is someone wealth and means. The traveler rode in a chariot. To the book of Isaiah, even having this scroll would mark it as a matter of faith and grace. They weren't all that common. Remember, in those days, every scroll of the prophet was found in the Great care was taken to the book in making sure each translation is perfect. Wondering, what does it mean to be a person of faith? What does it mean to be a Christian? What does it mean to belong to a church? The church elevated Philip to serve in the ministry of faith. His official concern about Pittsburgh was for people already professed to be followers of the way, the people who have already confessed Christ and know the Christ crucified. Consider your own role within this church. Each and every one of us plays a role in the health and vitality of the church. We have some who are elevated to be elders. Others are called to be deacons. Some serve on committees. Some are chairs. Others simply come, but all belong to God's grace. But with that membership comes a measure of responsibility. And it is incumbent on each and every one of us to listen to the nudging and urging of the Holy Spirit to share God and our faith with all of us. Each one of us has our own story to tell as to why we profess Christ, why we belong to the church, why we are members of the Christian faith. And we bear a responsibility of sharing our faith with understanding and those who are behind it. None of us is ever comfortable doing this. It takes a lot of courage, it takes a lot of guts to be able to share something so personal and so intimate that I think will cause us to do what we think, to share what we need, matter what we are doing, in order to bring others to know God. You know what? Here's a cool one. The angel of the Lord told him where to go, and the Holy Spirit told him what he needed to do. The faith of the person that he encountered is everything about this person driving this chariot out of his outsider status. Simply put, this man is not God. First, he is a human. He is He was no man, no real man, no full man. He was forbidden from participating in the temple rituals. Deuteronomy 23:1 states this: no one who has been commanded by trusting or cutting the testicles may enter into the temple. According to the law, he could not be called holy because of his pointedly sinful nature. Scripture tells us the whole point of him coming to Jerusalem was to worship. He wasn't on a mission from his clan. It wasn't diplomatic. He came for edification. The Ethiopian, his physical characteristics marked him as an outsider. He was scared. The blackness of his skin, his black feet, his strange his demeanor all proclaimed this man is not a man. And Philip's two words to this person, this demon, is an official in the court of Candace, the queen of Ethiopia. This person is in charge of the royal. So it makes sense that he is a human, because an impact man would not be trusted around the queen, especially since he's not a royal blood or citizen. So, this person came to Jerusalem as a leader of God's flock. The queen wanted to worship God and learn more about learn more about the God Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. As he traveled south, as the scroll opened, he's reading the prophet Isaiah, struggling to discern what these words mean. As Philip runs up to the chariot, he jumps to rest because his chariot is racing fast. He catches up and sees the reader, and he understands the text. Unless someone explains it to him. And so the eunuch decided the anxiousness to come and sit together. The same holds true for us. In our lives, someone was there to teach us what it meant to be a person of faith. They told us and showed us how to read the Bible, both critically for you as well, someone read you the stories of the Bible. They told you the stories of Jesus. They shared about Moses, about Noah, Abraham, and Isaac. We know the story so well. They began to be all complex. We've read about the series and heroines of the Bible. Someone took the time to make sure we knew God and Christ. And it's when I come across passages of Scripture and find something new and exciting from the old pages, even if I've read it 100 times, Scripture speaks to us in story of heaven, when we read God's story of heaven. Because it's today that we discover what God says to us. This is scripture that we read in the Bible. He was led like a sheep to the slaughter, and the lamb before his hearing is silent. Thank you. worship to come and see what we're about, how we practice our faith to put our faith in the invitation. And I know that God has sent it to us tonight to say,
Thank you.